Well, I get to be the bearer of good news this morning, and I'm so excited that I get to. I have a question for you. We're already stretching you in this episode of Grounded. How much scripture do you have memorized? Do you have a handful of verses memorized? I mean, John 3:16 is a good verse. We probably all at least have that one. Do you maybe have a whole psalm memorized? It's one of my life goals to memorize Psalm 119, which just happens to be the longest psalm in the Bible. You would certainly have to step outside of your comfort zone to practice memorizing scripture. I've heard a lot of women tell me they just can't do it. And that's true of every spiritual discipline. It takes discomfort. King David once famously wrote, "I have hidden your word in my heart." But you know what we don't get when we become Christians? We don't get a USB drive where God just inserts his word into our cranium. So we do have to have that discipline of learning it. And memorizing God's word can be challenging. Like I said, lots of women have told me, "I just can't." Well, today's good news guest has a challenge to that way of thinking. He's known as the Bible memory man, and he's going to tell us what's the big deal about Bible memory. Welcome to Grounded, Tom.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
Tom, how much of the Bible have you memorized?
Well, when King David counted the people, he got in really big trouble. So I try not to count verses and et cetera, but they say about 20 complete books.
Wow. Give us a taste. Share a little bit from one of your favorite passages.
Do you want something happy or something angry?
Yeah, let's
or...
give us happy. Happy.
Happy? Okay. Yeah. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth, who has set thy glory above the heavens. Out of the mouth of babes and sucklings hast thou ordained strength because of thine enemies, that thou mightest still the enemy and the avenger. When I consider thy heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon and the stars, which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him?
Amazing. Do you have some sort of memorizing superpower, or how is it that you're able to memorize so much?
It's really difficult for me to memorize. Well, the hardest thing, of course, is obeying it, but it's really hard. I mean, I have a life. I have four kids under 10. I have a full-time ministry, and I'm busy like everybody else. But, you know, God's word is a treasure, and it's worth laying up in our hearts. If it's in your hands, you're going to lose it or have it stolen from you. And if it's in your head, you're going to forget it. But if it's locked away in your heart, you own it and no one can take that from you.
Oh, man. What a great way of saying that. Just last week, I said to my husband, "My brain isn't working." He said, "Your brain's fine. You just try to keep too much in your short-term memory." And he's right. I try to keep about a billion things in my short-term memory, including scripture sometimes. And I love that idea of getting it into our heart. You sent something to me in the mail. I was so excited when I got mail from you. And it's a memorization study Bible. It's like a tool I don't know how to use. So teach us your process for memorization.
Well, I had the privilege of living in the Holy Land for 1,000 days. I earned 2 master's degrees on Mount Zion, and a lot of amazing things happened there. I met my wife there on Mount Zion, and we were engaged in Bethlehem in Shepherd's Field on Christmas Eve. And the cherry on top is we were married in the Old City of Jerusalem on the day of Pentecost. And one of the really amazing things, I mean, you live there for so long, you can do so many cool things. It's an easy place to fall in love, too. It's like, "You want to go on a date tonight and walk around the Mount of Olives?" Okay.
Sure, baby.
So, but I really learned how to memorize there from the best. And so the memorization study Bible, and you know, there's so many great study Bibles out there, Aaron, right? But there isn't one dedicated to the all important principle of hiding God's word in your heart. Like, we give lip service to memorizing scripture. We all know Psalm 119:11. We sing the song, but nobody does it if we're honest with ourselves. And that's a different subject, but I learned there how to do it. And so to answer your question, it's basically three ways, which are all fleshed out in more detail than the memorization study Bible, but reading aloud, because no one reads aloud in the West. That's so important. To stare at the page, the power of format. Then number two is to hear it. We really don't hear God's voice throughout the week in the literal sense. If you think about it, you know, when we read the Bible, we read it with our lips sealed. When we're in the car, we're listening to whatever. I mean, in my world, it's whatever DVD's playing on the back for the four kids, you know?
Right.
When we go to when we go to church on Sunday, you know, it's all good. You know, we pray and we do all those kind of things. And don't get me wrong, I know we need verse by verse teaching and preaching and application and commentary and et cetera, but we don't hear the book of Revelation from memory or 1 John from memory. So we don't even hear God's word, which is sad because the Bible is originally meant more for the ears and the eyes. faith comes by hearing, be doers of the word, not hearers only. So there's an orality of scripture that has been lost, but we're getting it back inch by inch. So number two, listen to it. And then number three, and finally, is how I do it, which is to write it out and say it when you write it.
Well, I'm a write it out girl all the way. I recently just kind of had an epiphany that Jesus's words in the gospel are the only words from Jesus I'm going to get in this lifetime. And they're Jesus's words. They came out of his mouth. So to hear them, obviously I'd love to hear them from Jesus's own mouth audibly, but to hear them, there's power in that. So everything you're saying, I'm kind of wrestling with in my own walk with Jesus. I appreciate your humility. I really do. And I know that you've been empowered by the Holy Spirit to memorize scripture. Memorizing the third of the Bible is a feat, but you are our good news, because I feel like you represent what happens when we are obedient, when we're willing to be stretched by God to do things for his glory. So what has been the impact in your own life of memorizing so much of scripture?
Well, that's just it. You know, why should I do it? I mean, many people are self-defeatist. Oh, I can't do it. Well, then I can't help you. You know, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Number one, last time I checked, right? But look, I mean, just do a verse a week. You'll see that you'll be able to better defend your faith. You didn't go from ooze to the zoo to you by a series of time and chance and over billions of years. God created you in his own image and his own likeness. He's made you a little lower than the angels. Number two, it provides words of comfort in times of need. I got a call last week. My dad just dropped, not dead, but just dropped, almost dead. Like, where does your mind go? Where does your heart go? Where do you race to? You race to the memorized scripture. You can't fumble through your Bible sometimes or pull out your phone and swipe around and look for that right verse. You need to have it on the tip of your tongue. And also provides words of comfort for other people. You know, I mean, you don't know what you know how it is. You get tongue tied. You don't know what to say to someone when something terrible happens. But to speak the right verse in the right context is like apples of gold and pitchers of silver. It's the most valuable, precious thing you can say to someone. Comes from the word of God and nowhere else. Also, two more quickly, it provides us with our weapon of choice. Your kids and your grandkids' weapon and your weapon is the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And if I was to take away every single Bible in the world, not me, let's make a bad guy do it. If a bad guy took away every Bible in the world, okay, where are you going to fight? What are you going to fight with? You only have what you have stored up in your heart. And think of Jesus tempted in the wilderness. What does he do under distress? He speaks the oracles of the living God from heart. And there you go. And then finally, it puts the mind of the living God within reach. It helps you set your affection, your mind, your heart on things above. It keeps you stayed on Yahweh.
I'm in, man. There's more than enough reason there to start memorizing scripture. What about those four kids of yours? Are they memorizing God's word? And how are you doing that as a family?
Well, you know, I'm not an ogre who like, you know, you must memorize. I want them to want to do it. So at bedtime, you know, I'll, from my proverbial Rolodex, they can hear whatever scriptures I have memorized. And, you know, this is like Deuteronomy 6, right? Recite these words is like the original intent of that meeting. It says teach in many, but recite these words to your children. When, where? And you know the verse, when you're sitting at the table, when you're walking by the way. In other words, we're supposed to be able to have the word of God on the tip of our tongue and to be able to share that with our kids throughout the course of daily life. And that's what it's all about. But if we don't have the word of God hidden in our hearts and it's not on our lips, how do we expect to be able to instruct our children in the way which they should go?
Amen. Our boys, we sing the doxology with them every night, and we repeat the high priestly prayer to them as we're tucking them in. And I just know that that's going to bubble up in them in the future. It's been sung over them, said over them their whole lives, and it comes straight from God's word. Well, we picked you as our good news today because we think you're going to inspire women to memorize scripture for themselves for all of the great reasons you've given us this morning. So say there's a woman in Brazil watching this morning, or in Iowa, or anywhere in between, and she wants to hide God's word in her heart. Where does she start?
Number one, start with something that's manageable, okay? Don't overreach. Do something with light at the end of the tunnel. If you just did one verse a week from Titus, you do the whole book in a year. Or Jonah, whole book in a year. It's something, right, that you're kind of can already walk through and familiar with, and that'll help build some confidence. And you'll see it's going to be hard at first. It's like working out and exercising. You don't want to do it. But the more you do it, the easier it gets, and the more you see results, and the more you're encouraged that you're making a difference. And how much more with the word of God, right? You'll see that all those blessings that are going to come to your mind and to your heart through meditating on the word of God. And they can get more tips and techniques on how to do it at thebiblememoryman.com.
Awesome. All right. I hear a challenge there, grounded family. Pick up your sword and memorize it. Get it into your heart. Be sure and tell us about it. Give us that website one more time, Tom, where people can find out more about you.
Sure. TheBibleMemoryMan.com.
Awesome. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks, Aaron. You're the best.
Thank you.